Another important subtopic of this chapter is soma clonal variation and in vitro plant germplasm conservation. So these two important topic you will learn. So first of all, come to the clone. Clones are the morphologically and genetically identical progeny to their parents. And if you are asking the soma clones, it means these are the clones which are produced from the somatic cells by the process of tissue culture technique. So soma clones are those genetically identical progeny of the plants which is identical to their own parents, and they are the outcome of micropropagation or tissue culture technique. Now the question is, why do we call the soma clonal variation? Variation means there is something different, some genetical differences is taking place when the plant is regenerated from the cells or from the explant. So soma clonal variation refers to all those genetic variation which occur in the progeny plant rather than parents plant is known as soma clonal variation. Once again, soma clonal variation is a type of genetic variation in the progeny which is produced by the tissue culture or micropropagation technique, and these plants have some genetical variation which is not present in those cells from where they obtained. So there is gradual genetic changes takes place when a plant is produced in vitro technique. So the first of all, soma clones was executed or come into the existence by Larkin in 1981. So Larkin is the man who introduced soma clones in the year 1981, and these are the variant plants. Soma clones are the variant plants which is obtained by the process of tissue culture or by the micropropagation process. And these soma clones have very important role in the production of new breeds, new species in crop plants. Apart from that, they are used to improve the plant breeding program for the production of new species, new races, and they are also useful in the production of disease resistant plant, salt resistant plant, and water resistant plant. So all these sorts of qualities are due to the soma clones, and they are also useful in the production of the mutant. Production of mutant. Mutants are those genetically changes plant in which their genetic makeup has been changed. So this is about the soma clone and soma clone variation. Apart from that, nowadays what happens, we are opting this gametoclonal variation. Instead, we are using tissues like root, stem and leaf. If we are taking gametes like pollen grains, egg cell for the purpose of production of these clones, so we will use the term gametoclonal variation. So gametoclonal variation is the output of taking of gamete or gametophytic origin of the plants. Example, here we are taking egg cell, gamete or pollen grains which is cultured in vitro, and the plant which is produced having suddenly some changes, therefore it is known as gametoclonal variation. Soma clonal variation, we are taking a somatic cells, and here we are taking the gametophytic cells. This is the difference between the soma clones and gametoclones. So this gametoclonal variation, what we are using? We are using either these pollen grains or egg cell to produce the genetic variation. So these genetic variation which is present in the plant is highly different with the plants from where they have been taken out. Next, germplasm conservation. What is the meaning of germplasm? Germplasm dictate about the total number of genes present in the crop or its related species. So sum of the total number of genes present in a crop plants or its related species is known as germplasm. Germplasm is very essential because of it is day-to-day function is useful in production of different kind of breeds of the plants. Even it is also storage of some animal germ cells. So what are the different technique of collection or storage of germplasm? We will discuss here. The first one is in vitro plant germplasm. What happen here? In vitro means it is a synthetic method or it is unnatural method where we collect the germplasm from the plant origin and it is stored in aseptic condition so that we can use in future. In vitro gene bank is another approach of storage of germplasm, and here what we are taking, we are using cells or tissue culture. Cells and tissue cultures are coming in the in vitro gene bank. Now the in vivo gene bank, what the meaning of in vivo gene bank? In vivo gene bank means as it is, whatever the seeds, whatever the propagules, it means the vegetative plants which is produced by the root stem leaf, it is stored in as living form. So in vivo gene bank includes all such type of the seeds and vegetative propagules. Apart from that, nowadays we are using the pollen bank also. Pollen banks are the storage of different species of the plant of the pollen grains. We have stored the different pollen grains because each pollen grains have their own role, and whenever it is required, it is used to the crossbreeding program and to improve the inbreeding program in the improvement of the plant tissue culture or production of the disease resistant plant, etc. Cold storage. Actually, there is two approach: cold storage method and cryopreservation. If you want to store this germplasm for the shorter time period, then we apply the use of cold storage. Here we are using the temperature 4 degree to 15 degree centigrade only, and here we are taking shoot tip, root tip or ax plant. So for the short time period we are applying the cold storage method of preservation of germplasm, but more importantly that cryopreservation. Cryopreservation is a technique of storage or collection of germplasm, pollen grains, seed, sperm, other things at minus 196 degree centigrade in liquid ammonia. Here we are using the cryopreservant, that is a liquid ammonia, and the temperature is goes to minus 196. So the cryopreservation method is used for the long time period of storage of the germplasm, and cold storage method is having 4 to 15 degree centigrade is applied for the shorter time period. So cryopreservation is once again is a technique of preservation of germplasm at very low temperature, that is minus 196 in liquid ammonia. So this is all sorts of the method of storage of germplasm. Thanks for watching.